Friends, welcome back to the digital electronics class. And after registers and flip-flop, now we are discussing in unit 4 the last topic, counters. And I am your instructor, Priti Rani Rajvanshi, assistant professor, IMS Noida. So what is counter? Counter is a single simple sequential circuit. A digital circuit which is used for counting pulses is known as counter. Counter is the widest application of flip-flops. It is a group of flip-flops with a clock signal applied. Counters are of two types, asynchronous, or you can say ripple counters, or synchronous. So an electronic counter is used for counting the numbers of pulses coming at the input line in a specific time period. The counters must process memory since it has to remember its past states. Okay, so there are two types of counters, asynchronous and or you can say ripple counter or synchronous. So first we'll discuss about asynchronous counter. A ripple counter is an asynchronous counter where only the first flip-flop is clocked by an external clock. All sequential flip-flops are clocked by the output of the preceding flip-flop. You can see in the diagram. First flip-flop has a clock. Then in every flip-flop, the output of first flip-flop will be the input clock for the second flip-flop. So in other words, we can say in asynchronous counters, the clock input of all flip-flops except the first one are triggered not by the incoming pulses but rather by the transitions that occurs in other flip-flops. Therefore, the changes of state of a particular flip-flop is dependent upon the present state of other flip-flops. So you can see in the diagram, this is 4-bit ripple up counter, or you can say asynchronous counter. Yes. So as you can see, we are using JK flip-flop. So what is the quality of JK flip-flop? As you learned in the last classes, the JK flip-flop avoids the condition of invalid condition that was occurred by the SR flip-flop. And in asynchronous counter, there are three types of counters: asynchronous, ripple up or ripple down, or bidirectional, that means up and down both. Asynchronous also called ripple counter because the way clock pulse ripples, it way through the flip-flops. A 4-bit asynchronous counter is a external clock connected to the clock input of the first flip-flop FFO only. Sorry, FFO changes state at the negative triggering of each clock pulse, but FF1 changes only when triggered by the negative triggering of the Q output of FF0 because of the inherent propagation delay. FF2 changes state at the negative triggering of the Q output of FF1, but FF3 changes only when triggered by the negative triggering of the Q output of FF2. So you can see the counter circuit digital truth table. There are 16 input of clock, and Q0, Q1, Q3, Q4 are the outputs. Now we'll discuss about the 4-bit asynchronous ripple down counter. A 4-bit asynchronous ripple down counter is simple modification of the upper counter. 4-bit down counter will count numbers from 15 to 0. As you can see in the table, it counts from 1 to 16. Now it will count in upward, like 15 to 0, like 1111 to 1000 and onwards. The clock pulse of all flip-flops are cascaded at the JK input of each flip-flop is connected to logic 1. That means the flip-flop will toggle at each negative triggering of the clock signal. The clock input is connected to the first flip-flop and the other flip-flops is counter receive the clock signal input from Q output of the previous flip-flop rather than Q output. Here you can see Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3 are the counts. That means 4-bit down counter. The output of the flip-flop will change when the negative triggering of the clock signal occurs. For example, if the present count equals to 3, then the up counter of will calculate the next count as 2. The operation of the down counter, you can see clock is 0 to 15 and the output you can see they are upwarding. Like 15 has 0000 and 0 has 1111. Like this, 15 has 0000 and 1 has 1111 because this is the asynchronous 4-bit ripple down counter. Then we have bidirectional counter. You can see it has a circuit, fully circuit, like every flip-flop has a clock pulse, every output is generating a next output and giving it to the next flip-flop. The bidirectional counter works as count up and down depending on the status of the control signal up and down. When the up input is at 1 and down input at 0, the AND network between flip-flop 0 and flip-flop 1 will gate the NOR output Q of FF0 into the clock input of FF1. Similarly, Q of FF1 will be gated through the other AND network into the clock input of FF2. Thus, the counter will count up. When the counter input up is at 0 and down is at 1, the NOR output of FF0 and FF1 are gated into the clock pulse input of FF1 and FF2 respectively. So you can see up or negative is down, single output, single input, and then it get negate with the AND to go to next flip-flop, and all flip-flops are the JK flip-flop we used in the bidirectional counter. Next is synchronous counter. The counters which use clock signal to change their transition are called asynchronous counters. This means the synchronous counters depends on their clock input to change state values. In synchronous counters, all flip-flops are connected to the same clock signal and all flip-flops are triggered at the same time. Synchronous counters are also known as simultaneous counters. There is no propagation delay and no ripple effect in synchronous counters. So you can see 4-bit synchronous counter diagram. So we have a count enabler. In J and K flip-flop we have 4 JK flip-flop and we are using this 4-bit synchronous counter. So the C input of all flip-flop receive the common clock. If the count enable input is 0, all J and K inputs are equal to 0 and the output of the counter does not change. The first stage A0 is completed. This one is the first stage A0. Is completed when the counter is enabled and the clock goes through a positive transition. Each of the other three flip-flops are complemented when all previous least significant flip-flops are equal to 1 and count is enabled. The chain of AND gate generate the required logic for the JNK flip-flop input. The input carry can be used to extend the counter to more stages with each stage having an additional flip-flop and an AND gate. The inputs of first flip-flop are connected to high, that means logic 1, which makes the flip-flop to toggle for every clock pulse on entered into it. So the synchronous counter will work with single clock, single signal and changes its state and each pulse. So now this is the end of the unit 4. So let's quick recap the whole unit 4. Okay, so let's start with the sequential logic circuit. As you all know that the combinational circuit and sequential circuit has the difference of the clock and the memory, and we can store one bit in sequential logic circuit. So this is the sequential logic circuit diagram. That means combination circuit with a memory or feedback is the sequential circuit. So what are the types of or examples of sequential circuit? These are the flip-flop or latches or registers and counters. So we have majorly five types of flip-flops: SR flip-flop, set reset, D flip-flop delay, T flip-flop toggle, and JNK flip-flop, and the master slave flip-flop. Master slave flip-flop is not the specific flip-flop, as it's made up with the help of JNK flip-flop. Okay, so flip-flop stores single bit, and if you want to store more than single bit, so we will use registers. So these are the four basic types of flip-flop: set reset, JNK, D, and T flip-flop. SR flip-flop, you can see the output of one flip-flop, one circuit will be the input for another circuit. So the input is 1000. So you can say 00 is the no change state, as the it will hold the previous state. As I'll already discuss in the class, that we have a condition 11, where the condition will not change, as Q and Q bar need to change their condition. That will be the forbidden condition. And same with the there are two types of representation of SR flip-flop: with the NOR gate or with the NAND gate. So you can see there is no major change in the truth table. And then we have a flip-flop, clocked SR flip-flop. So if we have clocked added into SR flip-flop, so we have to add a AND gate at the side of input with the clock pulse, and then that input will go to NAND gate or NOR gate to give you Q or Q bar. We have thought of that by adding clock pulse, we might get 1-1 condition, not invalid, but it is not possible. So we move to D flip-flop. D flip-flop is delay flip-flop. So D flip-flop have only one input. So one input with second input is the clock pulse. So in a truth table will be 1 and 0, and clock pulse will be high. If clock pulse will be low, there will be no flip-flop working. If in only in one case clock flip-flop will be working, if the clock pulse is high. So if D is 1, then Q is 1 and Q bar is 0, that means set. Or if D is 0, then means Q 0, Q bar 1, that means reset. Then we have JK flip-flop. JK flip-flop is named as per their inventors, those who have invented ICs, integrated circuit, Jack and Kilby. So the diagram is of JK flip-flop is this: the AND gate and the NOR gate. The representation is this, and in JK flip-flop truth table we got the solution of SR and clocked SR flip-flop. That means the 1-1 condition, that because we got the toggle condition in Q and Q bar output. So what is toggle flip-flop? Toggle flip-flop is, it will switch the output. If we have output Q, then it will be giving 0 to Q and Q bar to 1. So these are the condition. Then we have master slave flip-flop. Master slave flip-flop is the dependent flip-flop, like one is master and one is slave. So it will be made with the help of JK flip-flop. And you can see in the diagram that we have clock and anti-clock, so that key if we pass clock or not clock to the slave, so if one master is working, then slave is have to wait, and if slave is working, then master have to wait. So then we have Next topic was the registers. So if we want to store more than one bit, then we can work with registers. And a register is a group of binary cells suitable for holding binary information. A register is a very small amount of very fast memory that is built into CPU. So we have four types of registers, or you can say mode of registers: serial in, serial out. That means only one input will be given, and serially it will go to four flip-flops and will get only one output. When we talk about serial in, parallel out, that means we will use four flip-flop to design a register, but input will be serial and output will get four output from four different flip-flops. Then we have parallel in, serial out. That means parallelly will give four inputs and will get only one output. And parallel in, parallel out means each input will be given as a parallel input, and each flip-flop will provide you a separate output. You can see in this serial in, serial out. Serially, we are inputting serially and getting output serially, because every output is of single flip-flop is working as an input for next flip-flop. So that will make a serial in, serial out mode for register. Then we have serial in, parallel out. So you can see we are inputting serially, but we are getting output parallelly. QA, QB, QC, QD. Then we have bidirectional shift register. Bidirectional shift registers are the storage devices which are capable of shifting the data either right or left depending on the mode of selected. So if we are when right or left is high, gates 1, 3, 5, 7 are enabled like this. This is the block diagram. That means mode controller M and M bar. We are inputting D 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 8 gates. And we have 4 D flip-flops. Then we have parallel in, serial out. As you can see in the bidirectional shift register, it also work as PISO. In this, we'll get only one output, but we'll provide 4 separate inputs. Parallel in, parallel out. You can see in the diagram, we'll provide parallelly 4 inputs and we'll get parallelly 4 outputs. Then, as in this class, we have discussed counters. So we have counters, asynchronous or ripple, or and synchronous. Counter is a digital sequential device that will go through a certain predefined states based on the applications of the input pulses. An electronic counter is used for counting the number of pulses coming at the input line in a specified time period. The counter must process memory since it has to remember its past states. Then we have asynchronous counters. So asynchronous counter, we have three types of asynchronous counter: ripple up, ripple down, and bidirectional. So this is the ripple up counter. That means it will count from 0 to 15. This is 4-bit ripple counter with the help of JK flip-flop. So Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3 are the outputs, and clock is the input, like you can see. And then we have 4-bit of ripple down counter. That means it will count as opposite from 0 to 15, but output will be for 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, and for 15, 0, 0, 0, 0. You can see in this, it was for 15, it was 1, 1, 1, 1, and for 0, it was 0, 0, 0, 0. You might get confused that ma'am is saying that 0 to 15, but here it is written as 1 to 16. So you can write it 0 to 15 only. Then we have bidirectional counter. Bidirectional counter, as I already discussed, that it will count as up and down both. So in this, we have used JK flip-flop and provide up and down both the output inputs, and output will get Q0, Q1, Q3, Q4. Synchronous counters, simultaneous counters hai, there are no propagation delay, no ripple effect in synchronous counter. So you can see counter enabler, and then we got A0, A1, A2, A3 for the output, and we are using JK flip-flop. So in this, the C input of flip-flop receive the common clocks. If count enables input is 0, all JK inputs are equal to 0 and output of the counter does not change. So thank you, class, and if you have any query, you can reach me on my number. You all have my number and my email ID. If you have any query regarding anything, you can message me or you can email me. You got this document on your WhatsApp groups, and stay healthy and stay home. Thank you.